When it comes to interest rates, the predominant thing to understand is that the markets are driven by interest rates, because wherever interest rates are going, wherever, so interest rates is essentially the price of money. Wherever the price of money is going, it has an impact on different asset classes. If interest rates are expected to go higher, it means that company valuation or stock valuations of companies will be lower. Why? The higher interest rates go, the negative it will impact the, it will impact businesses negatively, right? So it drives market, it drives on my indices, it drives on my equities. When it comes to currency, the higher the interest rate of that specific currency, the more attractive and appealing it is to investors. So it means what? It means capital will flow into their economy, especially if that economy has other economy and other fundamental data that is very supportive of that economy, right? Or puts that economy in a good position. So interest rates will drive what? Will drive that currency in that sense. And when it comes to Bitcoin, the stock markets or equities, Bitcoin is now used as an alternative form of investment to into a stock market, because Bitcoin moves more than a stock market, right? So that is just the primary understanding of my interest rates and the impact that they have. Rates that drive everything. It is because I'm talking specifically to this 10-year yield, which is the one that you can see in the yield or the benchmark interest rates. Why? Because each dollar is a world reserve currency, right? And the 10-year yield, everything or most things are pegged above it. When I say most things, I mean debt, whether it's mortgage debt, credit card debt, car financing or car loans, personal loans, student loans, whatever it may be. It is pegged above in above the interest and your 10-year bond yield, right? This specific bond yield is essentially a driver of everything. Like I said, the dollar is a world reserve currency. Every economy has some form of debt, or it has some form of interaction with the US dollar, right? One of the one the biggest debts in China is denominated in dollars, right? So they want to ditch the Chinese, sorry, the US dollar, trade with the BRICS or trade with whatever other form of currency they want to use. It's gonna be difficult because 80% of China's debt is in dollars, right? So the dollar is a power engine. It's a world reserve currency. No discussions about that, or no questions about that. So we can use a benchmark yield of what is expected with the market, right? And that is why I say the interest rates drives interest. So how does inflation in the same direction, right? If inflation is expected to go higher, then it means that that central bank is more likely to do what? To increase interest rates. So then what? Interest rate expectations are now going to, the currency will follow. It will follow in a positive direction, your interest or your yield. But stock market, as Bitcoin, cryptocurrencies will go in the opposite direction to my interest rate. Because like I said earlier, when interest rates go up, it's going to hurt businesses negatively, and it's going to impact the cryptocurrencies negatively. Why cryptocurrencies negatively? Because the cryptocurrencies are now viewed as an alternative form of investment to any to a stock market. So essentially it moves the same way as the stock market. If stock market is going up, crypto is going up, right? So in essence, if we look at the 10-year bond yield, and then we look at, let us okay, I've already mentioned indices, so let us look at the index correlation between the two, right? When one is going up, do like this. So as you can see here, so as you can, when the bond yield peaked, peaked, it topped at around October 2023. What did we see later on? We saw the stock market bottom out, and then we're going lower. We saw AMA indices starting to go, indices and interest rates go in the opposite direction, because like I explained, negative impact of higher interest rates on businesses, so on and so forth. Negative impact of interest of higher interest rates on consumers. Benchmark 10-year yield or US started pushing higher, right? The indices has now started to turn lower again. Yes, it has been moving up. See, indices are now starting to push higher again. So to a certain extent, there is that. If we look at the bench, let me change it into a line chart. So as you can see, so when the Nasdaq bottomed out at around October 2022, the US 10-year yield topped at around October 2022. Fair, not exactly the same time, but interest rate. What did we see? The stock market started. Treasury yield had finished. We saw a correction go. We saw Nasdaq continue. Inflation drives interest rates, because around October, November 2022, that is when inflation had peaked at around 9% in June, I think. I think it, and see if we can do it here. Peaked at around core inflation. Yeah. July inflation, as you can see, was at 9.1. Stock markets bottom. By the time we got to October, inflation had been dropping from 9% for the next 2 months, because July was 9%, then August it dropped. September it dropped. So July, August, September, October, so yeah, as you can see now, core headline inflation was now at 8.2. In July, it was at 9.1. In October, it was at 8.2, if you can find it. Around September, as you can see, around September, it was at 8.3. So inflation has been going down for the past since July, essentially, since it formed a high of 9.1 in July. So since inflation has been going down for 3 months, and previous to that, just that I don't have my spreadsheet open, previous to that, inflation was going up since 2021. Then inflation has been going up until increasing interest rates in October, sorry, not October, but March 2022, right? That is when interest rates started going higher in the United States. And as you can see, green and black candlesticks, which is the U.S. And as soon as it started going up, what happened to our NASDAQ or indices? They started going lower because they have that opposite direction, right? So wherever my interest rates are going or are expected to go, my indices will drive cryptocurrencies, it will drive currencies, it will even drive gold, it will even drive oil, right? So everything is essentially driven by interest rates. But there is just interest rates were going up and inflation eventually peaked at around, like we saw, 9.1 in around July 2022. And then what happened from there, inflation continued to go lower, but interest rates continued to go higher in the United States. And that is why we can see that it continues to push higher. Sorry about that. There's someone who wants the meeting ID, but we're already in the meeting now.
I'm starting to understand.
Yeah?
I'm starting to understand the role of interest rates. Starting to make sense.
Yeah, it's as simple as that, really.
So can I ask?
Yeah.
If for instance, right, we have the Reserve Bank meets target.
You're not audible. Ngicela unyusela kancane your voice.
Is it?
Yeah, now you loud and clear. Perfect.
Oh, okay. So the question that I had was in regards to if, for instance, the Reserve Bank meets its target, for example, let's say whatever target they've set for themselves, does that now mean
income to what? We need to be specific. Target of what? Not of a number. Say it should mean they've set a target. Yeah, targets for interest rates, target for unemployment. Okay. Correct.
Okay, they set the target for the interest rate, ne? Does that translate to the fact that now the markets are going to be consolidating, or still the markets are going to be trending in whichever direction that, you know, I don't know if it makes sense, or kanjan?
I'll try and answer based on my understanding. If it does not answer your question, Ungjen, but they don't set a target for my interest rates. They set a target in inflation, because if you want to understand, I'm trying to show you what inflation is, the cornerstone of everything. Where is inflation right now? Is it rising? Is it falling? And where is inflation expected to go?
Okay. Right?
So that will actually give an indication in terms of what happens when it comes to our interest rates.
Okay.
Right. So we don't get in Akuzan, we don't get a target in my interest rates, but we do get a target, yani, your inflation. Can you still hear me?
Yeah.
Okay, so that is essentially how it is, right? But it depends how far are they towards a target, the inflation. Are they close? Are they very far? Or what is happening? And that is what will determine how the central bank actually acts. Yeah, so when it comes, inflation peaked at 9.1 and then it had started to go lower. So if inflation is starting up since 2021 and then interest rates started going up in March 2022, and in July 2022, inflation peaked at 9.1, continued to go up until March and October. But what is the thought process? Inflation has been going lower, which why? Because they started hiking or increasing our interest rates. That's why inflation peaked at 9% and now it's going lower, which means that interest rates are starting to work on the economy. So what are the expectations at that point? If interest rates are expected to go lower. So if interest rates are expected to go lower, what does that mean for Inakuzan? What does that mean for AMA indices? Indices will go
Go higher.
exactly. So that is why we saw it bottoming out of in of right. So that is why we had it bottoming out of AMA indices here, and they started going up. Interest rates drive everything.
Makes sense.
Okay, so that is essentially what we had there. And then if I also look at the form of invest coin, same thing. Let us switch to candlestick, but it around November, October 2022, when AMA indices, when US telling what happened with the with Bitcoin, when they when interest was when interest rates start, rate started rising off of Bitcoin. You can even look at Ethereum, it's the same thing. And then it bottomed out and started pushing higher when now because it's inverse relationship to AMA interest rates. When interest rate almost that is why we say interest rates are the drive of everything. But for you to understand where interest rates could potentially go or where they are going, it is paramount that you understand inflation. What where is inflation? Is it rising or falling? And where is inflation expected to go? Because that will give an indication of what the market is expecting central banks to take interest rates or to with interest rates, right? So that is what we you need to understand when I say that interest rates drive everything, right? Let us actually go chart cleaner on the weekly chart. But when the yield starts to fall, Bitcoin pushes higher, right? With the AMA indices, pretty straightforward. AMA currencies, they're obvious. Because it's a US 10-year yield, but you can even look at Euro. Let us look at Euro USD. But since the dollar is a quote currency, then Euro USD should not be going what? Should not be going in the same direction as same pattern as what? As AMA indices. So as you can see, when we topped out at around October 2022 on a US 10-year yield, Euro USD bottomed out. And when US 10-year yield started to push higher, right? And then when were interest when did interest rates start to March 2022? So it's around it was falling already, but it continued to fall very hard and from 9.1 in July and 2023, and then in October 2023, around the time interest rates in the United States were now expected to go lower because inflation was, and that is why, and this is when we saw the bottoming out of Euro USD and Euro USD. That actual dollar or USD currencies very goes pretty much almost the same way as Ilan does. Obviously, this is a United States bond yield. And the dollar here is a what is a base currency. So it means that it will mimic almost to the, you can see when interest rates started going up, you can see black and white candlesticks, that is USD JPY. What happened with USD JPY? Sharp move higher because interest rates were going up in the US dollar, in the United States. So it was the interest rates. And that is why I say interest rates drive everything. It will start to fall lower around October when everything else that goes in the opposite direction to my interest rates started pushing higher. What happened with AMA interest rates? They were falling. USD JPY goes with AMA interest rates. What happened to US higher? When the yield started falling again around October 2023, as you can see, what was happening with USD JPY also started pushing higher. So that is why I say interest rates drive everything. Is it making sense? So did it answer your question?
Definitely, yeah.
Okay, so yeah, that's the main important thing when it comes to interest rates. And then Kensani, do you have any questions? Kensani, do you have any questions?
Hello, I don't have any questions right now.
Okay, this is a Q&A session. So I'm not teaching. I only answer questions.
Okay.
It seems as if I was teaching right now, but I was answering who gives question just that when you joined us a bit late.
Yes,
If
yes.
no
Okay.
questions, then we end the session because there's no questions for me to answer.
So, okay, I have a question. I have a question. Can you hear me,
Yeah,
Mylene?
clearly.
So these setups. So do these setups occur once in a while, or can it be an everyday thing, or we have to go according to the economic calendar, or
Why do
things
you
like that?
why I'm gonna ask you, I'm gonna answer your question with a question first. Why does it matter if it happens every single day or occurs every once in a while?
In order to catch those entries, my leader, because because you see,
Because you
sometimes
probably
you might find
want to make money every single day.
that something like that.
No, it doesn't work like that in the financial markets, guys. It doesn't work like that. If you having that mentality, you're just setting yourself up for failure. The market will give you setups when it gives you setups. When, how many per month, I don't know. But it will give you setups when it gives you setups. That's all I can really say. So
Okay.
when it comes to trading, especially with fundamentals, there's two ways. There is the longer term, the swing trading type of format, and this is essentially what I've just explained in a nutshell. Then there is short term, which is essentially day trading. For day trading purposes, that is when we're trading based on the economic calendar. If we're having CPI or inflation figures being released for the United States today, we know that that is important, that is significant, because whatever number that we have there, it will have an impact on what? On interest rate expectations in the United States. So we can look to then day trade on that specific day and trade the news release and wait for the data to be released for us to get the number. And then with our understanding of fundamentals and the impact that whatever that number is will have on the financial markets, then we can decide whether we're buying or selling the dollar. Right. We're also not guessing. We're not entering before the news release. No. We wait for the news to be released. And then we have a number that we can co make a conclusion from whether to buy or sell the dollar. That is day trading. That depends on the economic calendar. That you probably will have
Okay.
it every single month because we're always getting inflation figures every single month, unemployment data every single month. And another thing, the reason I was answering you with a question initially, it's because we are not limited to trading one thing, right? Remember, we are not guessing here. We are using fundamental
Yes.
analysis. So since we are using fundamental analysis, it expands what our horizon and it allows us to trade any asset class over any time horizon. So we are not concerned about the opportunities that the market presents us because we are not only saying we are trading on Nasdaq prepared. And if there are no opportunities on Nasdaq, then we're stranded. We don't know what to do. We're now going to start forcing trades. No, here, whatever they're willing to trade, that is what we trade, right? If there's no setup on gold, we can look at Nasdaq. We can look at Bitcoin. We can look at
Okay.
currencies, right? So, in terms of opportunities, it's not really relative what you can fix a certain number, which these are the certain number of opportunities that I can expect every single month. No, that is the market. The market will decide for us. But then again, we have a wide variety of instruments that you can trade because we are not limited to one thing. Because once you start limiting yourself to one thing, you're essentially limiting yourself. There's nothing about it. Yes, some might say it makes them profitable. That's for them, but essentially it's for me how I view it, you're just limiting yourself because you are not really certain about identifying market direction. So you are always guessing in market direction. So now we are born with, if I start looking at every other asset class that is available for me to trade, it's gonna give me a headache because already with that one currency pair or that one indice, if I'm only trading on Nasdaq, I'm always guessing the direction there. So how much more if I now have to guess over 100 different asset classes? No. So I fix myself or I limit myself to one thing. But if you're trading with the fundamentals, because if you understand interest rates and inflation, it gives you a broader horizon in terms of what to expect, Puma indices, what to expect, Puma cryptocurrencies, what to expect, commodities, gold, oil, currencies. Then you can pick and choose whatever you want to trade based on what is supportive. It's supported, sorry, by fundamentals, right? So at that point, you are not limited to the opportunities. You can have multiple of opportunities. Some you decide to take, some you decide to ignore, even though they are there.
Okay.
Yeah.
Thank you, my leader.
Okay. So, okay, Gift, you don't have any other questions, eh?
Yeah, I've got a question. But angazi ukuthi ngayibeka kanjani ne. Can the geopolitics on a short-term basis overrule the long-term sort of like thesis of the interest rate? For example, let's say the bond yield is moving, for example, on a downward trend, right? It's going down, Then, for example, safe haven commodities such as gold are moving in the opposite direction, né? Then there's some geopolitical sort of like things that are happening. Can that event on its own sort of like change the direction and tend to move the bond as well as, for example, gold in the same direction? Is that possible?
Okay, I'll answer you
Yeah.
right. Let us go to AUD, right? Australia is a commodity currency, right? Because Australia exports iron
Yeah.
ore to China, so iron ore is a commodity. So in terms of geopolitics, what sort of risk environment does it put the market in, or the sentiment that it creates is a sentiment of uncertainty, fear, and panic. That is essentially what geopolitical factors do. So in that case, it means it does not benefit commodities. So if it does not benefit commodities, what does it mean for Australia? It means Australia will not benefit in a risk off environment. And what did we have? This was Friday the 19th. This is when I think this was when Israel, sorry, I think this was when Israel retaliated to Iran, if I'm not mistaken. But that is what was happening here, right? As you can see, Australia is a commodity currency. CHF is a safe haven currency. What happened? We saw because of what? Because of the geopolitical side of things, because of what was happening based on the geopolitics, right? So we saw what? We saw a spike lower in AUD CHF because that meant that Swiss franc, a safe haven currency, is getting inflows of capital compared to Australian dollar, which is a what? Which is a commodity currency, because the markets were now not really certain what the next or the response would be from Iran. Because previously they had what? They had responded by sending missiles and drones towards Israel, over 300. But now this time around, the markets were not really sure. But what happened as the day progressed, Iran played everything down. They said, we're not going to pay attention to this. We're not even going to retaliate, blah, 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 blah. What happened? The market corrected itself in line with what the fundamentals were saying, or what we were already anticipating with fundamentals, that Swiss franc is weak because the Swiss National Bank are cutting interest rates. Inflation is low for the Swiss economy. Australia, inflation is relatively high, and they continuing to maintain what? Higher interest rates, right? So this is essentially a perfect example where geopolitics almost changed what we were anticipating, But when there was no what can I say, how can I put it, when there was no follow through in terms of the whole geopolitical thing, what happened? The markets resumed as normally. Does that answer your question?
Yeah, it does. Yeah, it does answer my question. Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah.
So yeah, that is what that is a perfect example that I could think of. Okay, I think we're gonna how long have we been going for? Okay, I think we're gonna end it now. Do you have any other questions? Kensani, Kensan.
Yes, I do have one last question, my leader. I
Okay.
wanted to ask that when you use technical analysis, do you perhaps use Fibonacci tools? Do you use tools like Fibonacci retracements or not?
Okay. Yeah, we can use that. We can use that. There's nothing wrong with using it. I do use it. Remember, a technical analysis, how we're using a technical analysis, well, based on this approach, right, that we've adopted of using fundamentals to find the direction. How we use the
Yes.
technical analysis is we use the technical analysis as a filter, right? So a technical analysis is the last step. We're using it as a filter, as a risk management tool, if I may call it, right? Because that is how we're able to see what's okay. This is where we're looking to enter. This is how much we're looking to risk and a stop loss set and all of that, blah, 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 right? So when it comes
Yes.
to Fibonacci, we can use the Fibonacci. I do use the Fibonacci retracement for I'ma take profit targets, for I'ma take profit objectives, right? Looking at 127, looking at 168. But the ultimate take profit for the whole position is when the fundamental picture changes. So we do use Fibonacci. But like I always say, you with whatever you use when it comes to technical analysis, guys, you are spot on. You are spot on. Whether you are using simple basic support and resistance, you are spot on as long as you understand the direction. Just even with this simple example that we have here that we were talking about of AUD CHF, even using just basic support and resistance, you could have, as long as you understood the direction based on fundamentals, simple, very easy. Very easy. It doesn't really change. Whether you're using AMA trend lines, as long as the trend line is in line with the right direction, with the right fundamental direction, any pattern, any technical analysis tool works if you are in line with the direction. But if you are on the wrong side of the direction, I can teach you everything you need to know about technical analysis, but it will not work for you because you are on the wrong di you're on the wrong side, sorry, of the market, right? So you have actually taken the wrong direction, right? So we can even go back to before you join, right? So we can look at Kensan. I'm gonna upload it on YouTube shortly. Once it's done, I'll upload it on my YouTube, so you'll have to watch it, so that why indices have been going up
Okay,
because of what was
thank
happening
you.
with the ind all you had to do in this case was just use any technical analysis tool, whether it's support and resistance pattern, whatever strategy that you're using. You don't even have to overcomplicate it to SMC of patterns, a lot of whatever. No, it's not necessary if you are on the wrong side of the market. But if you are on the right side of the market, any technical analysis strategy will work. That is what I can tell you. And that is the unfortunate part that is how retail traders get stuck in the cycle of hopping from strategy to strategy, because they use once they try to continue use the very same strategy because they're only getting anything new to buy all this way here. And then now it's no longer working when the market is pulling back. And since you are impatient as a retail trader, what are you going to do? The strategy is no longer working. You stop using the strategy immediately when the market starts pulling back and it's no longer as you are selling the market. When the market starts going up again, that's the new strategy is no longer working. What are you doing again? You're now jumping and looking for another strategy. And that is the downfall of retail traders. And whatever the chart is doing does not change your conviction. Understand that there's a pullback and you continue using support and resistance or whatever strategy that you use. So in essence, is that it is not about the Fibonacci tool. It's not about what other tool do they use? But yeah, it's not about a Fibonacci tool. It is about understanding the true market direction using fundamentals. Then a Fibonacci tool will work for you. It will be effective. The only time a Fibonacci tool will not work for you, it is because you are on the wrong side of your market. That's just simple and straightforward. So I always say you do not need to learn anything else about technical analysis. Whatever you know, especially if you've been trading for more than 6 months, whatever you've learned with regards to technical analysis, it is sufficient to make you profitable if you are good at fundamentals, because fundamentals will give you the direction and the technicals is just about the entry in the right direction. Does that make sense?
Yes.
Yeah, and did it answer your question?
Yes, my leader.
Okay. So that is a pleasure, brother. That's the most important thing. The technical analysis is the last part. It is the filter in terms of, is it now the right time for me to buy? If the fundamentals are telling me to buy, are we now back at support for me to buy? Is this now back at a what other tool do they use? A flag pattern. Are we at the bottom trend line of a flag pattern for me to buy? You know, all of those things become easier. They no longer become complicated and a lot of guesswork when you know the actual direction. So yeah, that is essentially my take on the technical analysis. Technical analysis, the most easiest thing. And like I said, if you've been trading for more than 6 months, if you're still trying to learn a technical analysis, you're wasting your time. And I'll be brutally honest with that. You're wasting your time because you won't learn anything new. You'll just learn the same thing in different formats. Because the person you'll be learning it from will be calling it something else. Instead of calling it support and resistance, they might call it whatever name they'll give to it. But you're still learning the same thing. So, I think it brings us to the end of our session, guys, because you've both had an opportunity to ask two questions. Thank you for tuning in. Thank you for your time. And I hope you found some value from the answers that I gave.
Okay, thanks a lot, man. Thanks a lot.
You're welcome.
Thank you, my leader.
You're welcome.
Also, Corey, I think now I'm getting it. So, Corey, I should always look for fundamentals to give me my direction.
Yes.
Then I apply my technical analysis.
Yes, 100%. 100%.
Thank you, my leader.
100%. You're welcome. Cheers, guys.
Cheers.